Hey, it's Fran, again at the bench, with my Tizo chronograph. Yeah, I don't usually wear a wristwatch, but I got this chronograph for flying. Because you really need to have an ability to, you know, to time things and everything when you're in the air, and you want to have a really nice big dial. So I got this large chronograph just for that. Did not buy it new, bought it secondhand, and got a very good price for it. And it's all stainless body. It's got a artificial sapphire crystal, so it doesn't get scratched up. And because of these like sapphire crystals with modern watches and a lot of higher end watches, you get titanium bodies or stainless bodies, and don't really show the wear. So, but yeah, I got this used, but the battery has died, and I have to change the battery, so I'm going to have to open it up, put a new battery in. But, also, I want to try and correct something that's really been irking me ever since I got this watch, which is the larger 60-second sweep hand is out of alignment with the dial, which is very frustrating to look at. So, with a chronograph like this, what you would think of is the second hand is actually considered a 60-second counter hand. The actual second hand is this little dial on the bottom, because that hand is actually geared with the hours and minutes hands. That's actually all one clockwork, just like a traditional pocket watch, which I carry all the time. So yeah, so a traditional pocket watch, your second hand is down here, which I'm very used to seeing because I carry around this 1927 Illinois every day, almost 100 years old, still going strong. But yeah, that's the actual second hand, and it's the same with the Tissot. That's the actual second hand. So a quartz chrono like this one, it's actually four watches in one, because you've got the primary watch, which is the second hand and the minutes and hours, right? That's all one watch. But then you also have the 60-second sweep hand, right? You have the minutes chrono, you have the tenths of seconds chrono, and those three different hands operate independently with their own independent steppers apart from the actual watch itself. So you've actually got like four watches in one, four different movements in one watch. And of course this also has the date function, which is tied in with the primary mechanism. But yeah, so this 60-second hand, it is not aligned with the dial. It's sort of in between. It's off of the dial artwork. Very frustrating to watch it go around, going between the little ticks all the way around the dial. So I want to pull the whole mechanism out and then see if I can nudge the second hand. I'm hoping that it's not directly hooked up to a stepper. If there's no gearing on this, then it's just going to move with the post, and then I really don't have a way of holding that post and nudging the second hand. I'd have to pull the second hand off. And I don't really have a hand puller. I really wouldn't want to try to pull, but I have to pull it off and then center it on the right on the 12 o'clock point and then push it down on. I don't have to do that. I just want to be able to nudge it. If it's geared, I should just be able to nudge it into position. But if it's direct drive onto a stepper, then it's probably just going to move the whole thing if I tried to nudge it. I don't know. Just gonna have to find out when I get inside. Anyway. Yeah, I got some new batteries. This should take a 394. I got a bunch of Renatas. So, a lot of watches will have a special point on the back where you actually pry it open. There'll be like a little raised lip. But this particular watch, it seems to be raised all around. And I do have an actual, like, official, back-removing tool, although I've never been able really to get a watch back off with this. I tend to like to use this little more specific pry bar tool to get under there and pop it off. Here we go. Oof. And there's a little grommet in there, a little O-ring. Now I can actually use the official tool. Get in there and pop it up there. O-ring, here we go. Keep that O-ring intact. Make sure it's not marred, okay. There you go. And it's actually got a Renata in it right now, 394, so yep. Here we go. And no leakage, looks good. Go. Alright, so, and we can see the little official second hand moving there. So, the set has, it has two settings. You pull it out, we pull the crown out to the first position, you can set all the individual hands, pull it out to the second position, you set the hours, minutes, traditional. First position, here we go. You can set the date. I think, yeah, so. I'm just gonna move it at 7 o'clock so we can see all the other hands. Clockwise, here we go. And what is the, what is today, 21st? 21st, okay. And while the crown is in this middle position, I can set the individual hands. Use this top button to choose the dial that you want to set. So, I'm gonna, all right, that's the seconds. That's the tenths, or to zero. That's the minutes. And now I want to advance the minutes to the top position. So I'm going to step it. Let's see, it goes in half-minute increments. There we go. So that's top. And now I want to choose the seconds indicator. Okay. Now I'm going to advance that to the top. But you see it's actually in the freaking reflection. You see it's actually in the halfway point there. Not actually lined up with the dial. So I'm going to try to get it to the 12 o'clock position. If I pull it out again, all of those hands will spin. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to put that in, take the battery out. Okay. So I take the stem out. I've got to insert a really fine wire into this release hole. It's going to release the spring so I can pull the crown and stem out. And the resistor is perfect, just about the right size. Pull the crown out to the first position. And it should go all the way down in. Yep. And just a tiny little push is all it takes. No pressure at all. Just a feather touch once you get down to the spring. Yep. And there's the stem and crown. Set that aside. There's an outer plastic rim that holds the face and the mechanism down. There's also two little slugs that are in the plastic ring, and those transfer the switches down from these buttons to the actual switches that are in the interior. And you gotta be careful that those don't fall out, so take a little pick. And there's a little there's little holes in the outer rim. You can stick a pick in there and just get under there. See? Right there. That allows me to pick up the mechanism, and I'm going to carefully lean it back so I don't drop out those little bits. Here we go. Here's the interior. There's those little slugs. And I'm going to have to very carefully reposition them when I put the ring back on. It's just hooked up directly to the stepper So I would have to pull the second indicator off of the post and then push it down back on the post in the correct position. But I do not have a fine enough hand puller. It's a very specialized tool, a wristwatch hand puller, and I do not have that tool to be able to do that. So yeah, the nudge method, I thought it would only work if there were gearing in there that provide a little back resistance. Oh well. I guess, do I want to order a hand puller just to fix this issue with this watch? I don't know. I just don't know. Not today. It won't be today. People are going to say, Fran, the watch is radioactive. It's a luminescent dial. No, they don't put radioactive material in luminous dials anymore. It's just a highly sensitized phosphorescent material. They've made phosphors a lot more efficient. So, you know, they act like photon pumps. You put them under a light and they'll store up energy. And then when you turn off the light, they will release that energy. But it's just phosphorescent. There's no ionizing source of energy. It's just using the energy of visible light to charge up the phosphor, and then when you turn it off, it glows. Some of these modern materials, they're pretty efficient. They'll glow for a while, but, you know, after a few minutes, you're not going to see the dial anymore. So, but yeah, there's no radium, no tritium in this watch. Lined up, back in place. I'll put the battery back in. All right. Very tricky. The outer ring here, it's got these two plungers that transfer the motion from the outer, you know, thumb controls down into the actual switches in the main body. Very tricky to make sure that you don't get them stuck under the actual switches. You have to kind of fish them out and push the outer ring in separately than the core after you get the stem in. But yeah, it works now. So now if I pull it out to the first position, okay, now I can select. Yep, and I can advance. So yeah, it's about as good as I can do. Can't adjust that 60-second sweep hand without a special tool. I'll have to think about whether or not I want to order a hand puller. Make sure that the little O-ring is not over the edge anywhere. Get it kind of centered how I want it. I tend not to have the body weight to be able to pop these on in one shot, so I do have a special tool. What you need is one of these. This is a press for putting the backs onto wristwatches. There's a lot of fireworks going on out there. This is a very handy tool. I've actually used this press for lots of like delicate press type work. But it just makes this, it makes it so easy. Pinch that one side, so just a little. That's it. It's back together. This is a really cool tool. I've used this for all kinds of things. It's one of those tools where when you actually need it, you really need it. Little mini press. Alright, well that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to all my patrons down on the Patreon. making all these videos possible, including this one, a futile attempt, but, well, new battery, but didn't manage to get that secondhand. Ugh, this is going to be bugging me. Anyway, thanks everyone on Patreon, and I will be, you know, back here at the bench or somewhere doing something real soon. Bye!
That's where I work. Berserk in my lab. It's where I work. Watching. Friend love, it's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.